About that, after some technical difficulties here, we finally got the stream up and running here. Sorry about that slight delay. So here we are. Oh, and it saves nothing. Excuse the slight. There we go. After some slight technical difficulties,
we're here.
Exactly.
We're live. We're ready to go. We're ready to win.
Not only that, but Saints are up by one stock.
Choose your fighter.
So we are now swapping players since Jason Flair here got taken out by their Falco. Their Falco was pretty hot.
It was.
Not gonna lie. It wasn't. I don't know. We have one Falco player saying that it was decent. Okay, it wasn't as hot as it possibly could have been.
I'd like to explain why this Falco was not hot. So, I think three separate times he did double jump air dodge, which, I don't know, that doesn't combo with anything.
You know,
he's dropping a lot of combos there.
It would help if when you do double jump, you actually press the A button and not the shield button to extend the combo.
Also, he did not use down B at all, and it's pretty good in the hero matchup.
You know, that is a very fair point. I saw a couple of kabooms and projectiles that landed that probably shouldn't have. I mean,
yes,
Falco, frame
definitely.
2 reflect, frame 2 invincibility. It was a little, well, actually fortunate for us to see. And now we have Noah, our Pyra Mithra player, coming in here.
Also, I think the funny thing is me and you both play Diddy and Falco, so.
I mean,
should be pretty warmed up to the matchup, I'd say.
Yeah. I was going to say, you play Diddy a lot more than I do.
Yeah.
But, I don't know. I'm not too concerned about that Diddy.
No, I'm definitely not.
I mean, he did a decent amount of shenanigans, but nothing too crazy out of the blue. So.
Noah is confident in this matchup, is what he told me. So, we'll see it play out.
I was going to say, all of our players should be confident in the Falco matchup. We have two Falco players here on the team, so.
Also, Hither just bodies Falco. It doesn't really matter. Go! Hands off my
He did the funny.
He did the taunt, yeah.
He did the Falco classic. Piece of
air-to-air Falco pretty well. Out range him towards. Just can't get too close to that.
or, you know, do something like that.
Yeah.
But, thankfully.
Bad thing though, Falco can't just hurt Hardman through, I think, very well.
Yeah,
between there, down there, forward there.
I kind of respect what that Falco was going for, but the timing was just off.
Yeah, true. Pyra can very easily down there, Falco recovery.
Falco is also decently light. Not necessarily light, but
true.
Light enough that a Pyra back air at like center stage will just
probably
kill.
Yeah. Forward smash will also kill.
Yeah. That's what he was looking for. Just trying to time it correctly. Also foresight.
Yeah, that's a big thing. You don't have a lot of Falco combos doing that. I know firsthand.
Yeah,
like that right there.
If it's not absolutely true and the Falco is not on his absolute A game,
of course I'd still come out.
Yeah, especially with online gear. I am surprised that that Nair beat neutral B. Usually there's a nice big meaty hitbox in the charging.
It's a good punish.
Yeah, and that looks to be a miss input here from Noah. But let's see if he can pick up this last stock.
Combos are getting a little better this game than last.
A little, but he didn't get that down tilt forward air drag down. And he missed the up air there.
This is not jump air dodging. You know, probably helps him a little bit.
I think that's why he's doing better.
Oh, you went the wrong way.
That is one bad thing about that upbeat. It is a giant hitbox. We kind of love to see that. And now, Creighton Mew is currently one stock above us. The Falco taking out the Pyra Mithra.
Choose your fighter!
And here we have our resident. See, I don't think you guys know Mario. I think Mario, I talked to him before, I don't think he's a fan of that matchup. Mario's just kind of real stubby. I think he is, like I thought, he is going
Wolf.
I like it. You know, that's not a great matchup. It really isn't.
Oh. I kind of like the Rob.
As somebody who has played against the Rob more than anyone in this entire team, what are your thoughts?
It is a very interesting Rob. I'll say that. I think he can cook.
Donkey Kong.
Oh, he's playing with us now. He's not going DK.
He is. I don't know.
I think he's just playing.
I would love to see the Tim Pink DK here.
I would love to see PK here.
Wait, that was decent. But
Olimar?
The Tim Olimar?
Lucar.
Okay, is choosing
he
Wolf
is.
Here.
He just wanted to get us a little bit too excited before the match.
Exactly. A nice little tease into what could have been another showing of.
Notice how Creighton is using Falco and the Creighton Blue Jays?
They are the Blue Jays.
And Falco, I mean, could be a Blue Jay.
I don't know what other bird he would be if not a Blue Jay. Well. You know, you kind of got a good point there. It is his name. although I don't think he's a Falcon.
No.
He doesn't have the head structure of a Falcon.
No, he does not.
All right, and with that, we are going into game number three here.
Mm-hmm. And only down by one stock.
Yeah, exactly.
So, nothing to fear. Realistically, best case scenario, Tim takes the stock without losing anything.
And I think that's probably what's going to happen.
We see the taunt.
I think any time there's a Falco on stage here, we are going to see the hands off my taunt here. And like this, now we start. Ooh, barely missing that grab there. The Falco.
I think he's getting a little bit used to online right now.
Yeah, exactly. One thing that we have to keep in mind is that online does not go very well in fighting games most of the time here. There's always going to be a slight delay versus how it actually feels.
You gotta be able to react.
Yeah, he does. Now the Falco there, reading the air dodge and getting that up smash. Tim returning with an up smash of his own here.
I could see Tim going for a side B here, just for fun.
I think he's gonna go for down. That's a little too frame.
I think he's gonna go for it now.
No. Down smash barely misses.
Uh-oh. He makes it back though. Oh.
That laser is barely stunting the recovery. What is this, Falco?
He's trying to show off a little bit and then
instantly getting turned around bodied like that.
Not the worst thing to happen. I mean, still losing a stock.
Not ideal,
but you know what? We're only down by one stock. It's not a huge lead or anything.
Exactly.
Getting used to online, so.
Exactly, and we also have to keep in mind, this is game one.
Exactly.
I gotta say, I know Jason is listening. Probably didn't have his full heart in the game because he knew that he was leaving.
Yeah.
But he did phenomenally.
Yeah, he did.
Only losing one stock.
When was the last time he played in what you call it? In a group battle.
I don't know if he has competed. I think he did compete in one crew battle for us last semester.
Gotcha.
But still an outstanding performance. Mm-hmm. From Flair here.
Yeah.
Taking three stocks and only losing one. Did a very good job. Mm-hmm. And against Diddy, too. I don't see that being a good, favorable matchup. We gotta look at the music choice here.
We have to. I'm gonna place my bets of a Persona song.
Oh, mm-hmm. We are going into the other category here.
Does he have a first? I'm a fan.
It's good. I just don't know what this is from.
I don't know either. It sounds like Xenoblade.
No, because then it would be in the Xenoblade category. Like, I understand where you're coming from with that, but I don't know.
It just gives Xenoblade vibes.
That is true. It gives classic Japanese JRPG.
Yeah.
Also, I like how I said Japanese JRPG. just to make sure. But it does give that JRPG sort of feel to it. Mm-hmm. And now we just kind of wait for the round to start.
And I think with that, we're starting now.
We are
Roy.
Starting against a Roy. Now, Tim does have a lot of Roy matchup experience. He plays the character. That's one of the real good things about playing so many characters like Ludd and I do.
He's trying to do the thing. He's trying to jump on his head.
Honestly, I respect it.
I do. I also got a little bit scared. You know, I thought maybe he forgot to die.
Yeah, no. You know, he just has to go for the footstool, put some in the, make some know that they're messing.
Exactly.
You're literally stepping on them so you can artificially suicide yourself. Ooh.
Okay. He should make it back.
Spot.
Yep. Oh! He doesn't make it back, but you know what? He got it.
That is a good trade.
It
no
is good.
No tech from the Roy.
Uh-oh.
That is a free 40% from the Roy there.
Down throw, dash attack, yep. Dash attack again, back air.
No jump.
Good. Ooh.
Almost.
That would have been clean, spicy.
That would have been truly a wonderful thing to see here. But honestly, even percents right now.
I think he lives. He does.
Yeah.
Okay, that's
Roy sweet spot side B. You know, do you we always hate to see it.
Yeah.
It is a bit unfortunate. Do you feel the fire inside of me? Do you see the sparks that I'm setting free? Does the beat take you over? You just can't breathe.
Yeah. And it happens.
Do you feel your bones start to shake? Do you feel the earthquake? Do you feel your bones start to shake? Okay. There we go. Already got him. Oh, and we already have jumped into the last set here, and Brian was only taking 40%.
Saving the rest for last?
Yeah. I mean, it's always nice to have an anchor here. Now Ryan charged up at the 69% here. Let's see what he can do. Already taking one stock.
I'm not an expert in this matchup, but I would probably say slight favor.
Yeah, I would imagine
if
this
I had to guess.
Yeah, being like plus one here.
Not by much though. Do Roy cheese things. This is a chair.
See if Ryan can equalize the stock count here. That should be death.
Yeah.
Just like that, with a little amount of rage on that, able to get the up throw up air. So now, what are your bets on who the last character is going to be here?
I don't even know. I mean, they've all been kind of fundies, high tier characters, I'd say.
Yeah, definitely. Especially
I'd say maybe like a Mario, if I had to guess.
We are going the DK rap here. We absolutely love to hear that.
They should have put the original in the game, though.
That would have been very nice to hear.
Way better.
Instead
of the remix is alright.
Yeah, exactly. It's not too bad. I don't know. I think a Mario could be seen here.
Palu, maybe.
I could 100% see a Palu.
What are like online characters that we've seen a lot? A lot of Palu, Roy. Seen some Marios.
Wouldn't be surprised if we see a Wolf of Their Own either.
Probably.
I don't know, comparatively versus some of the other teams that we've seen this season, this is probably the highest, not necessarily skill level, but the best characters rank-wise, yeah. Tier-wise.
And Falco's not even that good either.
Okay, he may not be that he's good, right. But he's still a high tier.
Yeah, he's high tier. Low high tier.
Yeah, exactly. Low high tier. But let's...
So it's Diddy, Roy, and Falco, right, so far?
Yep, Diddy, Roy, and Falco.
So just all my characters, basically.
Yeah. I mean, if we see a ZSS here, then it's...
then ZSS, it's, you know, they might be sniping our streams and...
I mean, Ryan does do. Honestly, I wish they hear what we're saying right now and then choose to go ZSS.
That'd be kind of cool. It'd be a guaranteed win, though, because ZSS is indeed a bad character.
Yeah, definitely. But let's... We just got to see what happens here. They are taking a little bit of time to do their stage bans, which I don't blame them. They did go from a 2-stock lead to having no lead and going up against our best player, Ryan. Mm-hmm.
So we just, Lauren in the pocket, though. You never know.
That is true.
We have to unleash the hammer.
Yeah, the Lauren Palu. We might get the first appearance.
The Lauren day one Palu was insane. I was firsthand. I know what it's like to get spiked twice.
Yeah, that was actually kind
that was
of
crazy.
Crazy to just have that be sent out.
What do you think about the Wolf-Roy matchup?
I don't know. It seems pretty even.
I don't hate it. I think Roy wins slightly.
Yeah.
I also, when I had that, when I was, like, playing really hot, and I went for that down air, if I went for a Nair there, I would have won. Because Nair trades really easy with the Roy's up B.
That is true. You can just snuff it out a lot. That Nair having
a
high...
One of the few characters that can actually contest Roy up B.
Yeah, it's actually kind of insane. We are still... Oh, it appears they have done their stage bans.
Snake? Okay.
Was not expecting to see a snake here, in all honesty.
I mean, it fits the mold. High tier character. Solid. All
good online.
Really. Good, very good online.
One, go!
For the run-up jab.
Let's see. Interesting little visual bug there.
He's recharge. I think Inkley can low profile the mage, right? Like, really easily.
Yeah. And they can just kind of, like, run around with that.
Do you know how easy the... upper is like a snake. I'm assuming it's pretty easy, right?
It's easy,
the way
but
snake is.
Yeah, the way his body is. But
I don't know if grenades play a factor into that, but you can snake kind of get out of it.
Yeah. Well, it depends on if he has a grenade in hand. Oh.
Oh, alright.
Ooh.
Oh, barely misses.
I greatly respect what Ryan was going for there. Now, the one thing that might be hard to do is actually kill with the up throw up air on snake. He is very heavy. We typically see him live to at least 130, 140.
Yep, Brian loves that combo. He knows.
Yeah, exactly.
He knows.
So I could imagine we see up throw up air shortly.
Oh, the trade.
I am honestly.
I was about to say he's got to look out for up tilt.
Yeah.
I can't think of really any other reliable ways they can kill this matchup.
I mean, there's always the setups with, like,
because it's so shifty.
But it's not necessarily easy to do here. Actually, just thinking, that's one thing we haven't seen Snake do a lot in this matchup is just throw out the down airs.
Ryan takes it.
Charging the F smash there. Actually able to get the kill. Kind of insane. Ryan now at 91%.
Not sure why he's throwing an up tilt now. Wouldn't kill.
Yeah, up tilt now wouldn't.
You just stale it at that point.
Yeah. Give him a couple more hits on the grenade.
Now it kills.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, look out. Can't land on his shield.
Although Ryan able to get at least 60% extra credit, almost 80 here now. Is he able to keep it up?
I don't know what that Snake was going for there.
He was trying to go for like
he was not in the kitchen for sure.
Absolutely not. Nowhere near the stove. Able to get the roll. That probably was a reaction.
Yeah. I think he was looking for roll away there, actually.
Yeah. Ryan now down on his last stock.
Up throw up air here. I think he knows his way to the top platform.
Yeah. He's trying
to
go
he knows.
For it.
Doesn't even see more splat on.
I feel like it's.
Because it can go pretty far.
Yeah. Ooh, the up smash. Barely catching the up beat. I feel like Ryan hurt us there.
Yeah. To be careful here.
Yeah. Gotta be very precise on how Ryan decides to play this.
Not sure why you can neutral here. It's wasting ink.
It's to get rid of the grenades.
There's better ways of going on grenades than wasting half your ink tank.
That is true. Ooh. Sadly, the roller was.
Oh, there we go.
And he touched the shield. Saints taking set one.
That's my captain right there.
Exactly. That is our captain right there. We absolutely love to see it. Now, that was a very close match. That Snake towards the end there, as soon as he got above 100%, he did not want to interact with Ryan whatsoever.
I don't think either of them wanted to interact.
That is very fair.
Scary situation for both.
Both players not in a, well, both players not wanting to lose that. Because that was the end of game one. I mean, down to last stock, last hit, probably for Ryan. Mm-hmm. I mean, one Snake up tilt or one good read on a down throw from Snake, and Inkling's just gone.
Yeah, he's pretty light. I don't see any reason for him to go Mewtwo here.
No.
The matchups are all just not in his favor.
Absolutely. And now we are going to go into game two, and What are your thoughts on the lineup that we had versus the lineup that we will have going into game two?
I was pretty fine. I think Perry would do pretty well against the Falco for sure. And probably Diddy too. He doesn't really like Diddy though.
To be fair, who likes playing against Diddy?
I actually don't mind it.
Well, there's not minding
it. I also play Wolf, so
yeah.
That's one of his worst matchups.
Exactly. Now, I doubt we'll see it happen, but Ryan does have a good amount of Diddy matchup experience.
Yeah, he does.
So they might, knowing that that's a bad matchup, there's a slight chance that they save that Diddy for the Inkling here. Now, I don't
think the Diddy would go last, though.
No.
I'd say he's probably, skill-wise, the fourth best.
Probably. I mean,
I'm curious to see if they switch over to anyone or switch characters.
I don't know. Well, that's something we're going to find out soon enough here. But I do believe we have... They left?
All right, we win. They forfeit.
If only that's how that worked.
How many people are watching?
We have 4 viewers right now.
I only see 1 in the chat right now.
I know.
It's a lot of Jason. Like, way too much Jason.
He is the only active chatter. It is. Oh, now we have 5 viewers. Still only 1 chatter.
Put an R in the chat for Ryan for clutching up.
R for Ryan. Now, we do just have to wait a little bit here to see if they enter back in. Sounds good. And yes, Ryan did take more stocks there. Now, we aren't necessarily sure who Creighton U is going to take play here. But I imagine we are going to see Harry going in. Just give me one. You know, we don't necessarily appreciate that Perry slander in chat here. His min-min online does go hard. Thank you very much.
I think any min-min goes hard online, let's be honest.
That is true.
If you press A button, you should win like 50% of the matchups.
If you can hold forward and press A and then B.
Or hold backwards and press A and B.
Yeah, exactly. Press down B to swap them out. I think you should be fine. But we do have Perry.
How good do you think Min Min is?
All right.
I think Min Min is.
I think they're high tier. I don't think they're top 10.
At least top.
I do not think they're at least top 10. I do not think Min Min is top 10.
Really? I think she's like number 6, number 7 maybe.
Wow. That's putting them.
She has so many like plus 15 matchups. It's hard not to put her up there.
That is true. But, I mean, that's like for the longest time people saying Pikachu was the best character in this game.
I think Pikachu's very good too, actually.
No, I think Pikachu's very good too. But for the longest time, people thought, oh, Pikachu's best character in this game. How many majors has Pikachu won?
Whatever ESAM did.
So, zero.
Glitch. Did he win a glitch?
I don't think he did.
What's the one where he beat Leo? What was that tournament?
That was
a while ago.
I mean, yeah, what? That was like Smash version 2.0. Like 2018?
No,
he
played
him 2019.
He played him 2021, I think.
Oh.
He got the back air down B to take
it.
Remember that?
That is true. That is very true here.
I also don't think ESAM plays the character totally right. I think Shiny is more of a better example of just camping and then going in and getting edge guards and stuff.
See, but that's not very fun. But then
it's
again,
not fun, but it works.
It does work, but then again, Esam isn't a very fun person to begin with.
Esam is not a fun person. He likes boxing ring. I don't know. I'm not a fan of him.
That is very true. Sadly, we cannot elaborate further on that.
But if you really want to know, you can look it up.
All it takes is one Google search and a YouTube video.
Esam did go boxing ring, so.
And now we're looking at the song choice, and I think we're going to end up judging them. Targets from Melee. It's a good song, but
not that good.
Out of all the options we have here.
I like Dual Zone, personally.
Dual Zone
is good. I'm a 64 enjoyer.
That's a... Escape from the
Sea. This is a top tier pick. I like this one.
Yeah, it is. And here we have the parry.
Mariah
going
Perry coming
in.
Against the Diddy.
Against the purple alt Diddy Kong here.
Literally just my Diddy.
It's also what Zero used.
Yep. Go! That's why I play it. I think every matchup, Minmin would be better except for this Diddy.
That is
I think Minmin beats Roy. Definitely beats Falco for sure. The Snake, I think so. And I think Perry knew that, which is why he's going Perry right now.
Now, what are your thoughts on this matchup here?
I think Diddy destroys Snake, honestly. You can argue like arrow off stage, outrange, but I just think Diddy has so much better tools than Pit.
No, I absolutely agree with you here, but I don't know. Diddy is a little stubby.
This Diddy is scrapping, I will say, though. He's not pulling banana very often.
Exactly, he's not camping with Nut here.
So banana bird, yeah.
According to Nintendo Lego 134, the funniest thing Perry could do here is play all of them.
That would not be fun really at all, I don't think.
You know, as one of the few Olimar enjoyers in this game.
You enjoy Olimar?
I do enjoy Olimar. Dude.
Give me any reason.
Are you?
Oh, the SD. Okay.
Ooh,
we take those.
Absolutely love to see that.
Perry simply outplayed him there. Nothing more.
Exactly. Simple mind games.
Diddy is stealing his up smash. So it goes later.
You know, that's what that side B was for.
Just throwing the banana away. I don't think... I think the reason this Diddy is struggling is because he doesn't know how to play around banana.
Yeah, that is fair.
And he's just not pulling it sometimes. Right there would have been a perfect opportunity to pull it. And just keep center stage.
Exactly. Keep center stage. Keep him on ledge. Not doing any of that. And I don't know. I don't think Minmin would be that funny. I genuinely think that the Olimar would have been funnier than a Minmin here. And
no, Minmin's funnier. Because I'm not playing against a Minmin. That's right.
Fair. And the Diddy just getting
a random
raw
smash.
F smash. But the extra credit here from Pit here, not that bad, 73%. Duck Hunt would be epic. Now this chatter knows what's going on.
I do like Duck Hunt.
Also, are you telling me with Olimar getting two up smashes that are true in a row isn't cool? That's not the coolest thing Sakurai ever did.
I don't think it's very cool.
I think it's very cool.
I'm just glad Olimar's not broken.
Yeah, the nerfs helped.
Helped
my Ooh. Diddy.
Go. Goes through down smash.
Down
that
smash?
Does a two frame.
Not sure what that Diddy.
Three monkey flips.
Yeah.
Edge guard, there we go.
Should. That does take it.
The other thing is, this Diddy, when he has banana, he just throws it. He doesn't really mix up anything. He doesn't try to side. Oh!
The parry reading the jump there. And the Diddy going straight into that forward air. Making the Saints up two stocks. And yes.
Pretty solid first game.
Yes, Jason. That explosion does deal 30 damage. It's a funny little thing. You can throw banana, trip them, and then do that.
And it's like a free 40%.
But you also take like, I think 6%, 7%.
Yeah. But it's a funny little kill option. I remember.
Oh, it definitely kills, yeah.
Yeah.
And a 2-frame's really good.
Yeah, exactly. It's the explosion is almost as big as like Ivysaur down air, which is crazy.
Insane.
That Ivysaur down air is bigger, but you know, Sakurai's vision.
Sakurai loves Pokemon.
I don't blame him. You know, being a Japanese game, I don't have a problem with how many Fire Emblem characters there are. Fire Emblem is so much larger in Japan.
Why do we need Crom in the game? Explain. What value does Crom bring?
Okay, you have a very fair, solid point there. I was trying to think of something, but... Like, Marth, Lucina?
I think Marth and Lucina's fine.
They're fine. Roy? Fine.
I think Corrin's at least different, which I appreciate.
So is...
Robin?
Yeah, Robin. I'm also a Robin enjoyer.
I'm a Roy enjoyer, so I can't complain too much. Except for when the Roy does things to me.
Yeah, I'm not saying that one on chat. Or on stream. People in chat can just read that. And I don't think Crom necessarily brings that at all.
No, not at all. I think we need more DK characters in the game.
Who would you add if you could add one DK character? Really? Not
you could have like
Kong?
A peach, like a Peach kind of float mechanic, but not really float, you know?
Oh, yeah,
like,
with
gliding.
A tail?
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
You could add a Sonic character. I think Knuckles would be fine. I'm biased. I'd add Ratchet and Clank. Or Sly Cooper or something, but that would never happen, so.
Banjo, best DLC character. Now that... Banjo, it's cool. I'm glad he's in the game.
His moveset sucks, though.
Wait, yeah, his moveset's horrible. I don't know why they decided to program him like
They
that.
Made him terrible.
They are sending in the snake. Wow. That is unexpected here.
Against Pit, too.
Because
I think
just down beat.
I think Pit does fine in this matchup.
Yeah, exactly. Three, two, one, go! Now, this is something actually genuinely kind of really unexpected here. Sending in their
I thought the same
game four
last,
or game one anchor here. Now, the thing is, the snake may be able to just do a lot with grenades and like pull grenades on any Pit combos. But
oh. So far going very well for Perry.
Yeah, really. Already with a 59% lead here.
So I know Snake's a quick camper, but I also think that Pit can actually out camp into this matchup between arrow and downbeat.
That
kind
is
of forcing
very
him to approach
true.
Sometimes. But the problem is Snake, I would say, is better option than close. What was that?
A grenade.
Was that up smash? Or... I think it was up smash. I saw up smash come out. I don't know what.
Up smash into down B?
I guess.
I don't know, but that's not a horrible trade for us.
Yeah, I'm fine with that. Put it on you, smash. Craziest trades in Smash Ultimate.
That'd be the second time Perry would be on in Smash.
I like that Perry's going for a lot of grabs.
Yeah. Now, unfortunately, nope. Wow.
Wow. Alright, I'm gonna get Ryan's opinion. I'll be back.
Perry was swinging a lot, but in a match like that, there's really not too much you can do other than swing. We want. Yeah, no, that last stock there was pretty hot from Ryan.
Definitely.
Yeah?
Very hot.
Are you going to next?
Oh, we're starting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I figured the road would come in.
Three, two, one.
Roy, I'm town. It's a little sketchy. Side B can't kill you at about 20%. Mm-hmm. So.
But I think Ryan will be fine.
Well, I think we'll be fine. It's just baseline looking at this matchup with a stage pick. Not a huge fan.
I think it went away. He's taking a sip of water.
It's a timeout strategy.
You know what? You have to respect it. Oh.
Are they not supposed to go to town?
Maybe they were supposed to go on a different stage. Game.
Oh, okay.
Gotcha.
Roy has a control problem. You want to respond to that, Perry?
To what? Oh, where's Shrek 2? No. It's not here.
Do you know who that is?
Yes.
Who is it?
My friend.
Who's it?
My friend.
Which friend?
You don't know.
Perry's a lot of friends, guys. Too many friends.
All right. Now we have the match.
Is that your 134th friend? you number them?
<You don't know.
laughs> Puts to him, Ryan. So I think Ryan, like, I can't remember, because Ryan either told me up throw upper on Roy is really easy or really hard.
Because
I remember him saying one of the two. I would assume it's probably pretty easy.
Yeah.
If I had to guess.
Roy loves swinging his sword.
He does. He does love the side B button. Or the move.
Long roller, not gonna hit. Ryan's just gotta get used to it. Mm. You know, just gotta play against the snake, so.
Now he's gotta play a scrapper.
That's not gonna
kill
though. Because he has the impeccable DI.
Going off stage. That's Roy once, that sucks so bad.
Oh!
Oh! We take those trades?
That was weird.
That was really
weird. But it works.
Oh, there we go.
And that
punishes
kills.
It. Yep.
Too easy.
So
too easy
to
for Ryan.
Any straight hit from Roy probably kills here.
Ryan, living.
I'm not seeing this Roy up yet, a shield yet. Which is pretty good in this matchup.
He might not know about it.
He doesn't know. He knows about back air, though.
Alright, best case for Ryan here.
Best case for Ryan is he wins.
Oh! There's the up.
Wait for the side B to come out.
There it is.
Yep, there it is.
And he's. Doesn't kill yet. Just wanted to tease us. He's gonna get it again.
Yeah, he'll get it. I'm not worried.
There it is.
There we go.
Smash. Not with the roller, but it works out.
He's gotta be careful with the ledge.
Oh, up throw. There you go. The easy percent to the roller.
Oh, there's any roller there. This Roy is only holding forward. No other thoughts are in his head.
Oh!
Yeah, that'll take it. It's fine.
That's fine.
You still my captain. Did a very good job.
Amazing. If I were to play Inkling, I would play it like Ryan. I would dedicate it to Ryan. Ryan is my Inkling.
But, yeah. Usually he does, we're playing friendlies, he does jab a lot. I really haven't seen him do jab a ton so far in the match, which is kind of surprising.
Might play different in crew battles compared to practice.
Because the thing I have a problem with is, or when I play him, is he has a 50-50 of he'll run up and grab me or run up and jab, and you have to kind of like react to one of the options. Mm-hmm. And it's so annoying because it's so good.
So I believe Adam's going in?
Adam is going in, yes.
Yeah. Do you know who he's playing? Who do you think he's playing?
I mean,
he has Falco.
He said Rosalina is like his main, but
yeah.
I'm not a fan of the Rosalina Roy matchup, so I hope he doesn't go that, but unless he's super confident.
I think Rosalina would be a good play. Just go for it.
Against Roy?
Go for it.
When she dies at about 30%.
Oh?
And Luma just explodes.
Maybe. I don't think we're starting yet.
I think the Falco would do pretty good here.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's going to go Falco or not.
They just have the Falco left, right?
Yeah. What is he? He plays Toon Link, Rosa, Falco. Do you count the Samus? not really, yeah.
No. He's kind of a for fun character. For goofs, for laughs.
For fun.
Exactly.
Ooh. Fox?
The Fox?
I don't hate the Fox pick.
Him, well, he's finally back to kick some tail.
Actually, yeah, I like this pick.
Yeah. Member of
the DK crew.
I think Adam's got this. You know, only has to take one stock, so.
I think so.
He's got this.
I hope he doesn't go to town.
I don't think he's going to town.
I hope not. What's it? Okay. Yeah, it's basic. How big do you think stage counterpicking is?
What do you mean?
Do you think it matters a lot, a little? Does it not really matter?
I think it just matters to your gameplay, your game plan.
Do you think, like, comfort's the main thing?
Yeah, definitely. At least that's my mindset towards it.
I'd say for the most part, yeah. But then you also don't want to take Roy to town ever.
Yeah. I like the hey and the yo. Let's go. That was a sad ass dude. Just missed the ledge.
Just pure depression.
Already starting off.
Starting off stealing his best kill move.
Now this is Adam's first debut in Smash Bros.
This is his debut, yeah. Hearthstone player picking up another game.
Saw Jason take four stocks.
There's the uppie out of shield though.
And there's only four stocks left for Creighton. So Adam could do it.
Probably is it's so hard for Fox to do a lot of stuff in this matchup because Roy has the hill. So you want to be close, but at the same time you don't in a lot of scenarios.
Might be getting used to online right now.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Wow, all right.
That's all right.
I don't think Fox is a very good online character. Do you think so? I mean, he's kind of mashy.
They should. Unless somehow they change, they should still have a combo. Okay. He's starting to get...
Yeah.
He's starting
more dash
to warm
tags.
Up.
He's doing more Fox stuff. Probably have to get out of the Rosalina brain.
Oh, he lives.
No way he's dead at 70.
The impeccable DI. that's gonna. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. We're chilling. You just gotta get used to this.
Just getting in there, up smash percentage. We need him to take the stock so we can see if it's a Falco next game. I think it's super important before you counter pick.
I think Adam is run up and up smash.
Just run up and up. This guy's a Mars enjoyer.
I like shield and up smash.
This Roy loves going up smash. Wow.
That hurts.
It's not an option.
You're heading in. All right, Adam. So, first crew battle.
Yeah. Very unfortunate.
Very unfortunate.
I must say, very, very unfortunate.
But you know what? You only go up from here.
Yeah, exactly. And Fox is definitely not mid online. I don't know what you're talking about, Jason. I am just washed. It took me too long to get warmed up.
Yeah.
All right, sorry about that. We had to talk to some of the people across the wall here. It just took me too long to get warmed up there.
Yeah.
It was a bit unfortunate. I'm also not used to the... Yeah, exactly. Hands cold from sitting.
Exactly.
But I just wasn't able to capitalize on a lot of things. It's also a controller that I'm not necessarily used to. I don't know. There were just a lot of things that I could have done better in that... In a lot of situations there, I just kind of floundered.
Yeah. It's all right. I mean, we have Tim. Take the last stock off this Roy. See what's next.
Exactly. Plus, we do have to keep in mind this is only game two.
This is only game two, and we are up 1-0. So.
Exactly. I think if I do go back in, the Fox is not coming out.
Oh, wait. Never mind. Wolf? I thought they had a wolf for a second.
Nope, that is the Saints here.
3, 2, 1, go!
So we saw Tim use Roy, or not Roy, Wolf last time on Small Battlefield, and...
Oh.
Oh, wait! Let's go! Yeah! Baby! Can we get a woot woot in chat?
Yeah, we need several woot woots in chat here.
That's huge. And you know what? That should have happened with Ryan as well, with the snake. Or it could have.
It could have happened.
It could have happened. But it's all right. You know what? That's in the past. Tim, a huge stock. Can we talk about that stock?
I know. The absolute ingenuity and genius.
Exactly.
Of Tim there.
To understand the game plan and like have the awareness.
I'm simply the better player.
We absolutely agree. The genius there.
Yeah, you just got to know the game rules.
Exactly. Not just knowing the game rules.
Interesting. He wants to run it back.
Yeah, that's not how this works. You don't get to run it
you
back.
You make a mistake.
You make a mistake, and you just have to take and accept your loss.
Exactly. You can't just go off and just start swinging your sword.
Exactly. It was that Roy mentality, man.
It is. It's happens to the best of us. It happened to Tim last semester, and he's learned from it.
He's learned from it and is now abusing it. And
exactly.
It does feel a little bad to have to rule book somebody.
Yes.
But rules are rules.
Exactly. And you shouldn't be attacking. You have to understand the game.
You know, as the great, I almost said late, HBox says, we take those.
Exactly, we take
rules
those.
Rules are rules for a reason. Exactly, and we let them get away with it for the snake.
Exactly.
And now they should have learned.
Yeah. They should have been aware.
Exactly. They should have been aware.
I think they want to run back. Rules. Honestly, we don't have to.
I know, rip HFox. I can't believe he was almost gone.
I don't get it.
Just what chat is saying.
Oh.
But no, just the pure ingenuity. Also to talk about, yes, Jason, my Rosa would come out if I play again.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I mean, the Falco's hot, but I don't know. There's something about it.
Changing the song. What are our predictions? Persona?
It's going to be some P3. Oh, okay.
It's the classic.
It is the classic.
Every Joker montage.
Also, Falco, if you're saying that Rosa would struggle less than Falco online, I don't know what you've been consuming in your spare time here, but that is not a good take. Falco does a lot better just because, you know, Falco can obviously just keep frame trapping as he does. Oh, they air dodge. Oh, that's a drag down there. Oh, they air dodge. That's an up tilt. Jason, almost every character in this game struggles online unless you're... Oh.
I don't think they can hear it.
Oh, I can make sure that they hear it.
We're just dancing.
There. What about now? And yeah, now they can.
Okay, cool. Also, now it doesn't look as awkward.
Exactly. Also, all of my characters require reading. Jason is actually finally acknowledging my characters are hard. Perry going to the last surprise single. We would love to see that here.
I have a beautiful singing voice.
Exactly. Love to hear it. Love to see it even.
Yeah.
I cannot say that on stream. All right.
Okay.
So we are still waiting. I guess they are swapping out, choosing stages for their Falco.
Yeah. Or for a different character.
I'm assuming.
Flat song. Okay.
Flat zone.
They just wanted to tease us with it.
Exactly. It's constantly what we've been seeing. Just, you know. Tim just is a tease when it comes to the music here.
Exactly. Sonic Heroes kind of goes hard.
And it's an amazing game.
I've never played it.
That is a bit unfortunate. Looks like I know what you're doing this weekend. I'm not sure if people can hear that, but we have at least three people out on the other side of the wall over here currently singing it. Singing the song.
They should come in here and sing.
We should, on cam.
Exactly.
You know, I'll make sure that I'll save the song and the Smash team for when we eventually do a karaoke stream.
I would love to do a karaoke stream.
Also, I would never run Ganondorf online. I'm sorry. Cool guy.
You've met him before?
What?
You've met him before?
Yeah, I have.
Yeah? Way back?
Yeah, we go way back, you know.
Back to middle school?
Actually, even before that, elementary school.
Elementary.
And looks like I was right.
Running we are going Falco.
With the Falco again here.
Now, in Star Fox, I've never played Star Fox.
Okay.
Did Wolf end up winning?
No.
We're changing the script tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Good. Down throw the dash attack. We love to see it.
Okay. This. I don't know what this Falco has done. He has completely changed up his gameplay here. Not sure at all.
To be fair, it is also Flash Person. if you lose. So might want to play a little bit more safe.
Yeah, but I don't know. There's just something about his play style.
Back air killing.
Disgusting back air.
Mwah.
And right back at it.
Back to back back airs.
Back to back to back back airs.
Running it back like Jordan 96-97.
Did you just see those four down smashes from Tim? I mean, it worked.
Beauty. You know what? That's the online special.
It really is. One thing that I would love to see with this Wolf is a F smash spot dodge, either up smash or down smash. That's the real online Wolf special.
I like the spot dodge down smash.
We know you do.
It's a trademark.
It is a parry. Yeah, Tim over. Hey, actually, he's looking a bit different than parry, you know? Just.
Oh! That's not going to kill just yet.
Bit not. Oh, he does jump back and doesn't get the full edge guard. Can the Falco do anything against it, though? Parry did get his switch from teammate. He did indeed.
Forward tilt killing, last stock.
Last stock. Let's see how much extra credit.
And only at 47%.
Here. Exactly.
Do you think Tim plays a little bit more conservative here?
I think he plays slightly conservative, but like baiting in approaches like that.
Oh!
The Wolf flash.
Ooh, I think he's gonna go for it again.
Oh, he
wants it. And
there
see ya!
Jumping off and landing the down air to have the Saints go 2-0 here.
We are proud of Tim.
We are very proud of Tim. That was a very good set.
It was.
I mean, other than some slight floundering on my part.
You know what, though? We still won.
Not only did we still win, that was an alley-oop.
Exactly.
I put it right up there for Tim, and then Tim just came down with the dunk.
Exactly. I'll leave.
All right, and now we have the Tim interview. Coming in hot after taking those three stocks off the Falco and getting that. You simply
hey,
just
four stocks. Don't forget about the
well,
Roy stock.
Yeah, I was going to say, off the Falco.
Super,
three
a lot of talent went into that one.
Three stocks off the Falco, but you just outplayed that Roy there.
Yeah.
You know, it's.
I think that was more impressive than the other one, actually.
Yeah, I mean, you were just able to get into his head, make him use that Roy mentality to just go off the stage swinging.
Oh, he has to mash. He's Roy.
Exactly.
He can't not throw out moves.
Mm-hmm.
So my thought process going into Falco was I have accounting homework. And I wanted to get it over with. I didn't want to go to set three. I know the Falco matchup, obviously. So, I don't know. I just didn't want to lose. I didn't.
You know, that's very fair. That's very fair. You know, I thought it was only fair to give you a nice little alley-oop into the dunk on that Falco there.
Oh, truly generous of you.
Yeah. You know, I figured, you know, with your accounting homework, you'd be able to get it done faster, so.
Exactly, yeah. Oh, my God.
But that was – actually, that was an alley-oop into a dunk, that final stock.
It was. I'm going to be honest, the whole last stock, I'm like, I want to be on Yeet Smash. I want to be parry for once.
You want to be parry.
And I don't think I went on Yeet Smash.
You know, you didn't, but
the
you won us the
down was not
game.
Impressive enough.
You did win us
that
the
is
game.
True. That is more important.
That is arguably more important here. I mean, honestly, great plays from everyone on the team today, except my floundering. But, you know, it happened. I was floundering.
You just got to learn not to go Fox on Wi-Fi.
Yeah, I was.
Why do you think Light just didn't do anything during quarantine?
You know, that's a very, very fair and solid point here. And I now know that for next time. And I will just go Rosa.
All right. Also, the other thing was I had to make up for my first set where I only took two stocks. Kind of embarrassing. So.
Exactly.
I guess the character I play, too. That's the worst part.
Yeah, exactly.
When you get bodied by a character you play or, like, you know the matchup, it's, like, it's so much worse.
Because, you know, like, there's being ignorant in what you, like, how you lost. You're like, oh, they're just better. You can just say that. But when you know exactly what you did when you lost, it just feels
it's
a
even worse.
Bit worse.
Like, if I lose to a Bowser Jr. online, I'm not, like, crying. Because I'm like, wow, I didn't know Bowser Jr. could do that. But When it was to Roy or something, I'm like, damn, I should have known what to do there.
Exactly.
I shouldn't have rolled away like I did.
Well, and with that, I think we are going to wrap up stream. Do you have any final remarks here?
You just played well. Everyone did, really.
Yeah. Now, before we end stream here, I do want to say, if you come around tomorrow at 2, there is the Rocket League Spring Minor, and that's a tourney that starts at 12, not 2, sorry, my apologies. And then we have Val in going in C-Val against OSU here at 3 p.m. So 2 big streams tomorrow. Come around, check them out, and go Saints.
Go Saints.